really is the most wonderful time of the year. And with all the Christmas parties and family gatherings, you want to have the most wonderful food of the year. And I'm not talking just figgy pudding. This is peppermint bark no-bake cheesecake tarts. I know it's a long title, but these are delicious. For the crust, I use just about a cup of crushed graham cracker crumbs, and then 2 tablespoons of sugar and 1/3 cup of melted butter. And you wanna press those down into here. I have this cool little tart presser thing, and if you don't have those, you can just use your fingers, no problem. And you do have to bake these off in the oven for like 5 minutes. I know I said no bake, but I mean, for just 5 minutes, and you'll have those. In the oven, the middle sort of tends to come up. If you just take them out, press them back down, easy. All right, put those off to the side. Get to the fun stuff. All right, in this bowl, I have 2 1/2 tablespoons of sugar, and then I'm gonna take 1 block of cream cheese. And you want this room temperature, because if it's cold, it's just not gonna blend as well. So I just pulled mine out in the morning and left it out all day. You don't wanna warm it up, because then it'll split and it'll curdle. All right. Okay. I'm gonna blend this up. Try not to get any out on the edge. Once that's fully incorporated, you're good. And then now to the peppermint bark part. Right here, I have 4 ounces of white chocolate chips, and I'm gonna stick this in the microwave for 1 minute at 30-second intervals. All right, and the reason I do it like that is you don't want it to burn. If you stick it all at one time, it can just burn, and so you want to take it out 30 seconds, stir it, and then put it again 30 seconds later, stir it up again. Okay. And then I'm going to stick 1 teaspoon of vanilla in here. All right. And then also right here, I have 1/2 cup of crushed peppermint candies. And oh, I have my white chocolate ready. Get a knife to stir it. And what I did with these is I just took them out of the wrappers and I just stuck them in a bag and I just sort of crushed them with anything I could find. It's really just whatever you can do to find it. It's really easy, nothing much. And I'll add these in after I add the white chocolate and blend in the vanilla with it. All right, get all that good vanilla in there. And the white chocolate should be fully melted after a minute. If it's not, you can stick it in. Try not to do too much over a minute. That looks perfect. And then grab a spatula. Mmm, smells delicious. All right. I'm gonna blend this up. All right. And then after that, I have 1 cup of Cool Whip, and this is just gonna make it really light and frothy. And here, let me get this spatula. And you just want to fold this in, not stir it, because you don't want to lose all the air in it. So just kind of go from the edges and stir it in, or fold it in. I need to take my own advice. All right. And once it starts looking good, you can go ahead and add in your peppermint candies. And make sure you get all of those in. All right, it's looking good, y'all. Okay, so I'm gonna pull out our bases, okay? And to get it on there, I'm gonna get a bag and some scissors. And what I'm gonna do is pull our cheesecake filling and stick it in the bag. I'll just show you with a couple of these. I just want to take it to the edge. I'm just going to snip a part off this bag. If I can get it. There we go. And you just want to start with the middle on these. And go out to the edge. And swirl, and you have a nice, cute little cheesecake tart. And you can see the little peppermint pieces. So we'll just do a few of these. And these take about 4 hours to set up in the refrigerator. So, I'm going to set these over to the side because luckily I have some that I did last night. And here we are. These are the peppermint bark no-bake cheesecake tarts. And they have set up quite nicely. You can look at them. The swirls and the nice little graham crust. They look beautiful. And so here I'm going to go ahead and taste one. It is so good. And you actually can crunch on some of the peppermint pieces. That's one tip that I did want to say. You want to make sure that you don't crunch up the peppermint too small. You don't want it all to just be powdery dust. You want to have some big chunks in there as well. It's really great. You can taste the white chocolate. It's very delicious. Guys, make sure that you always have good food, good company, and send some kisses from the kitchen. Okay, let's taste it. Mm-mm. So good.